Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý. A lot of you have asked for this video. I am going to specifically explain how you can create controllers for facial morph targets and how to do it in CAD. So you can still use CAD's layer system, saving and loading of animations and all the other advantages it brings. But as you all probably know, facial rigging is quite a complicated topic, to say the least. And I am not going to explain the general problematic of facial rigging here, nor do the whole rig in this video, because that would take hours to do. Before we start, however, I want to mention I have started a new creative brand with several people called MIA. And currently we have a giveaway where you can get a free logo animation just for a like on our Facebook page. If you are a YouTuber yourself, or you have a small business, or you are just in a need of a new logo animation, hit that like and you might get it for free. The link is also below the video. Okay, but let's get back to Barry here. He has already all the morph targets created for the head. As I said, I am not going to explain the details of how to create these or how the morpher modifier works in 3ds Max. I have all the poses already set up in the morpher here, and we just need to make it for CAD, which this whole video is about. Okay, so first thing to do, add a new bone to pelvis. Unlink it so it's not linked to the pelvis anymore and zero out the bone. Now create a simple basic box. And also zero it out. Let's change its dimensions real quick. And apply edit poly modifier to the bone we have created, not the box. Attach the box to the bone. And delete the original bone shape, so we have only the second box left. And because we have attached it before, it now acts like a regular cat bone. You can now collapse it to editable poly again and done. You can also still see the original bone with this checkbox if you wanted to. Now let's do the whole process again for another bone. It will start to make a bit more sense pretty soon, don't worry. The only difference here will be different dimensions for the box. Make it a bit wider and also rotate it by 90 degrees. Do the same thing with edit poly and attaching it, like we did before. So now we have only these two boxes left. But as I said, keep in mind they still act like regular cat bones. We have just replaced the original meshes of the bones for our custom meshes, so they can have a specific shape we want. Let's also rename the bones. The white one will be the controller, let's call it mouth open, and the second one will be the border or a frame for the controller. Okay, we already have almost everything we need. We have to link the controller bone to the frame one, so it always moves with it, and also zero it out again if it moves. And now the fun part begins. In helpers, you will find an ExposeTM object, which stands for Expose Transformations. This is exactly what we need. Create one and align it to the controller bone. For the Expose Node parameter, add the same bone. And also link the helper object to that bone. Now everything is set up. Just one more detail is missing, of course. We have to connect this controller to the specific morph target in the head's morpher modifier. For that, you need to select the ExposeTM helper and head to Animation, Wire Parameters and Wire Parameters again. Now find Local Position Z, because we want the up and down axis to be wired here, and after you click it, click on the head mesh where the morpher modifier is applied. Head to Modified Object again, Morpher, and here find the morph target you want, in our case mouth open, the first one. This dialog window will appear, which might look a bit scary, but all you need to do here is to set the control direction and connect it. Now if you move our controller bone, you can see the mouth is opening and closing. However, now the value of the z-axis exactly represents the percentage of openness of the mouth, so 100 represents 100%. But that's not very practical for us. We want the value of 20 to be the 100%, not 100. So we can just multiply the value by 5 with adding this text and hit update. And that's it. 20 is now the maximum value for opening the mouth. Now to be even more fancy, we can set up some additional things. Select our controller bone and head to link info in hierarchy panel. switch to animation controller and hit additive to set up both. Go to motion panel and for the Z position axis, apply float limit and limit it from 0 to 20. Now as you can see, you cannot move the bone further. Also, you can lock the X and Y axis. And one final thing to do. If you now create a new layer, the float limit will not work. I have shown this before in another video as well. You have to set it up again for one layer. And then go to link info and hit remember layer settings. Now it will apply for all the future layers as well. So there you have it. I know it's just the one controller, but from now on it's basically the same thing over and over until you have the whole facial rig finished. You can do as many bones as you like and you might end up with something like I have here. You can hide the helper objects so they don't get in the way, but it's actually the same process over and over. Anyway, with this setup, everything you animate is actually a cat bone, which gives you a lot of freedom. And it doesn't mix with regular max bones, so it stays a clean cat rig. I hope this will help some of you guys. In today's age of the internet, where information is everywhere, there aren't many occasions anymore where you have to learn with trial and error or just piece together fragmented chunks of information from 5-year-old forum posts. However, with 3ds Max CAD, it's still sometimes the case, and facial rigging is an example of that. It's a bit advanced stuff, but nothing that complicated if you know the basics already. Anyway, thank you and thank you to all my Patreons. Also, visit my Facebook page I have mentioned for a chance to get a free professional logo animation. And see you in another video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.